Yes. Generative AI is what everyone seems to be talking about. And the speed at which new AI updates are rolling out is crazy. For the past few months, I've been testing out a bunch of these AI tools and categorizing them, and some of them will completely blow your mind. So let's quickly understand what types of AI tools are out there and then jump into some of the best ones. There are four basic types of multimedia content, and they can be consumed in different formats. Text can be chats, blogs, documents. Audio can be speech or music. Image can be 2D or 3D pictures, memes, graphical models. And video can be 2D or 3D recordings or vlogs. But after a while, these lines start getting blurred. Video itself can be a combination of image, text, and audio. You can also combine all these types to get outputs like feature films or gaming or websites. All AI tools will take one of these tools as input and convert them into either the same type or a different type as the output. So with this simple categorization, let's look at some of the best AI tools to start testing today. Let's start with the already popular text-to-text. By now, I'm sure you've already tried out ChatGPT. But if you want to try ChatGPT 4, you can either get it for free with Microsoft Bing, or you can buy it with ChatGPT Plus. Google has not only introduced Google Bard, but is also planning to introduce a conversational mode to its Google search. If you've already been using ChatGPT for your work, and you're ready to pay for a more refined content generation tool, then you should try out Jasper. But personally, I feel that tools like Jasper might run out of differentiating factors with the speed at which GPT models are improving. If you haven't already, head over to Discord and try to generate some stunning images using Blue Willow in their free test channels. While Midjourney has a limit for free usage, Blue Willow seems to be free for all at the moment. The implications of having such tools are endless, with more and more business use cases popping up almost every day. You can also try out Dall-E, Stable Diffusion, or Night Cafe. But practically, Blue Willow solves all your image creation requirements at the moment. Leonardo AI promises to make this whole process much more easier with a simple user-friendly website. Google Bard has also tied up with Adobe Firefly to generate images inside a chat window. It'll be interesting to see how this competes with OpenAI's ChatGPT along with its Dall-E. Let me know in the comments if you would like me to do a more detailed video on how to use all these text-to-image tools. You can also use Luca to generate logos for your company based on your specific prompts. Text-to-video. Google Imagen promises to be amazing at creating 2D videos from simple text, but it's yet to be launched. Kaiber is already available at creating text to video, even including audio. Runway ML is really good at this. It lets you create stunning videos with simple text, and it even lets you choose the style of video that you want. Versy converts your text into an entire 3D space, and it even lets you connect these rooms together. It's crazy to think of the impact this will have on interior designing and the metaverse. Meta also has a text to 3D tool, but it's yet to be launched. Maybe this is the saving grace for Mark Zuckerberg's metaverse vision. Text to audio. Personally, as a musician, I'm super interested in this space. You might have seen this viral video of Leonardo DiCaprio speaking, but with different voices.
As if pretending that climate change wasn't real.
That was by 11 Labs. It lets you upload your audio and uses that audio profile to read any text, while keeping the vocal texture, emotions, and the length of pauses between words. Mubert lets you convert text to music, but its text generation is still not there yet, but I'm sure it'll get better soon. Soundraw is similar, but without the text prompt. So it lets you select from standard options, like mood, genre, or themes. Wavtool simplifies music production, which is otherwise a very complex skill to learn. Image to text. Meta recently announced its Segment Anything model, or SAM, which could identify objects in images and videos, even in cases where it had not encountered these objects before. It might be interesting to watch this get embedded into Facebook and Instagram and see the tool generate funny captions for you based on the images you upload. Speaking of funny captions, memecam.io lets you upload an image and it converts it into a meme. I tried testing this with pretty boring pictures like a wall or a fan, and the results were quite funny. Image to image, 2D or 3D. NVIDIA Canvas lets you draw basic shapes and it converts them into hyper-realistic processed images. Autodraw lets you do the same thing but for quick icons and graphics. Runway ML lets you extend the image's boundary, where the AI would come up with its own suggestions. Maybe it's time to find out who was sitting next to Mona Lisa. Reimagine Home lets you visualize your home interior design. Deep Nostalgia lets you upload an image and it adds some slight animation to it, converting a static to a dynamic image. LeiaPix converts your photos into animations and also gives it a bit of a 3D look. Image to video. Luma Labs takes an image and converts it into a navigatable 3D world. It also has a plugin for Unreal Engine, which lets you add this 3D world into a game. Open world, high definition games are gonna reach a whole new level very soon. Video to video. NVIDIA Broadcast lets you edit the audio or video of your existing video. It even fixes your eye contact. I think that's gonna be super helpful for content creators or news reporters. Maybe we don't need teleprompters anymore. As mentioned before, Runway ML lets you do a bunch of AI video editing, like making the video slow motion or removing objects from the video. Wist Labs lets you take a video from your phone and it converts it into a 3D model that you can explore. NVIDIA Omniverse lets you create and edit 3D models. Audio to audio. Poly.ai is an AI voice assistant to answer customer calls. Google Duplay, which was supposed to do this in 2018, was partially discontinued. Maybe they might bring it back to compete with such tools. There are many more interesting AI tools that I couldn't cover here. But I've put together this free Google Sheet where I plan to track and categorize these latest AI tools. I've also highlighted which ones can be used for free and how to use them to improve your productivity. So join the community and let me know your feedback and suggestions. Thank you for watching.